Assalamu alaikum everyone, it's Yaz Espaz. So I just released my last video last week on the reveal that I'm pregnant again, alhamdulillah. Today's video, I really wanted to talk about Suleiman's nighttime routine. I have an 18-month-old son. Routine is so important for babies and toddlers and even children, and in general for even adults. You know, we all need some sort of routine in our life. So I want to talk to you guys about from when Suleiman was a baby, like I want to say 2 months old. Like, we've been on this routine since then. Alhamdulillah, he sleeps beautifully. Doesn't mean that it was always that easy up until 6 months. 6 months is when I started sleep training him. But I can make the sleep training video maybe on another video. But this time around, I'm just going to talk about his nighttime routine. I'm going to make this a quick video. So the first thing that we do before we go to bed, Suleiman is in bed by 7:30 every day, unless it's like, you know, daddy wants to play with him a little more, or we're out with the family or something like that, and we're driving home, so then he'll be in bed by 8-ish, or those random events out. But most of the time he's in bed by 7:30, and this is the routine that we do. So Suleiman has dinner around 6 o'clock. After dinner, I mean, it takes like 30 minutes to feed him dinner, because, you know, we read books. You know, he's always, he has to be engaged in something while he's eating. So he's either coloring, or he's got books, or we're doing flashcards, or anything that helps him learn. He's, you know, he does that while he eats. So he'll have his dinner, then he'll, so let's say we're done by 6:30. From 6:30 to 7, he'll be playing. Hopefully daddy's home by that time, and he's playing with daddy and all this stuff. And after he plays, at 7 o'clock, we put him in the shower. Since he was a newborn, daddy would always shower him, so he would carry him and then wash him in the shower. He, till this day, he's not a bath baby, he's a shower baby. And yeah, we just love to have him with us. And of course, when he's a little bit older, you know, he'll be taking a bath because he'll be wanting to play with his toys and stuff like that. But for now, we've been doing that in the shower with him, because we don't have a tub in our room. So yeah, pretty much we shower him. I want to say his shower lasts for a good 20 minutes, and then the last 10 minutes is when we do the nighttime routine, which is after we get him out of the shower, he's played with daddy, he has his toys there, he's gotten the nice warm bath, which children absolutely love. I take him from my husband, and we call him a mummy because we wrap him in with his towel and then I lotion his feet and his legs. I put his diaper on, we brush his teeth. He brushes his teeth every day now, twice a day, and we clean his ears with a Q-tip, and I clean out his nose with the Nose Frida in the event that he has some mucus, or now he can blow his nose a little bit. So most of the time I just get the Nose Frida to clean out his nose, so make sure his mouth is clean, his nose is clean, his ears are clean. We brush his hair, we put his pajamas on. And while my husband is showering the baby, before this process I just told you about, I get his bottle ready. Whether it was breastfeeding, but at this moment, now that he's a toddler, I'm giving him a bottle. I'll give him 6 ounces of bottle. So I have like 3 ounces of milk and 3 ounces of water. Just so, I don't know, don't ask me why, that's just how I do it. I do like 2 ounces of chocolate milk, 1 ounce of whole milk, and then 3 ounces of water. Don't ask me why I do that, it's just, he likes chocolate, he likes the taste of the sweetness of the chocolate milk, and you know, that's just what I give him. But I'm starting to lessen the amount that I give him at night, just because he's literally like on the verge of overflowing his size 7 diaper, you know what I'm saying? So, and there's nothing greater than size 7, so I'm just gonna start having to lessen the amount. So I've been giving him 5 ounces at night now, and maybe I'll just lessen it to 4, just so he doesn't, you know, wet his pajamas or anything throughout the night. But anyway, so I prepare his bottle, I heat it up for 30 seconds, and then I put it back inside. So when he comes out of the shower, he knows that he's gonna see 3 things. He's gonna see his blanket, he's gonna see his tete, his pacifier, and he's gonna see his bottle. He's gonna see those 3 things sitting right on the counter when he's in his pajamas and he's ready to go, right? So as soon as I finish putting on his pajamas and everything, we come out to the kitchen area. I put his blanket over his shoulder. He gets all comfortable, I tell him to relax. I give him his tete just so he doesn't, you know, get all fussy and whatnot. Before I give him his tete, his pacifier, my husband asks him, Suleiman, what does the cow say in Arabic? He's like, al-ba'ra tamil zay. And he goes, boo. Oh, it's the cutest sound ever. Boo. He says, boo. his lips get all. It's so sweet, mashallah. But anyways, yeah, so that's his question every night. What does the cow say? Boo. Then we go into his bedroom. I put his sound machine on because Suleiman, I know everybody's telling me, you know, you should get him off the sound machine, you know, so he can get used to noise and stuff. But honestly, at this moment, I cannot get rid of the sound machine because it's a lifesaver for me. You know, it is what it is. He listens to rain or a waterfall, something like that, or a water stream. That's what he listens to. And I'm slowly putting it down, but you know, he sleeps with the sound machine. It is what it is. He's been doing it since day one. But when he was a baby, a newborn, I used to sing to him like these Spanish lullabies or just in general some English lullabies. And it got to a point where I'm like, why am I singing him this when I could be reciting Quran? And this is the part I really wanted to get to. Why am I just singing to him when I can recite him something that'll be beneficial for him and will protect him throughout the whole night and, you know, and stuff like that. So I started, once I officially memorized Ayatul Kursi, which I was so proud of myself because it's a pretty long surah, you know, I don't speak Arabic and all, but I was so determined. And one of the Ramadans when I was married, you know, throughout marriage with my husband, I was telling my husband I have to memorize Ayatul Kursi because I knew halfway and I just didn't know the other half by heart. So once I officially memorized it, I said I'm going to start reciting to Suleiman Ayatul Kursi, and then I'm going to do the three quls: Kul huwa Allahu ahad, Kul a'udhu birabbil falak, and Kul a'udhu birabbin nas, three times. Throughout this whole time he's drinking his bottle, I'll say Al-Fatiha. First I'll say Al-Fatiha, and then I'll say Ayatul Kursi, and then I'll say the three quls three times. So Ayatul Kul Huwa Allahu Ahad, Kul A'udhu Birabbil Falak, and Kul A'udhu Birabbin Nas. And I'll do it in a very soothing voice. For me, I feel like I'm reciting it, but I guess in a way I'm saying it with a little bit of a lullaby tune to it. Like, not a lullaby tune, but just I'm saying it very smoothly so that it's a relaxing sound for him. I don't know if I should like say it right now how I do it, or I should just make a completely new video. I think I'm gonna make a completely new video like right after I just shut this one off, just so that you guys can play it in the event that you want it. But I don't want to be in the video. I just want to recite it to you guys. So please don't judge me when I do record that video. I don't know if people are going to be like, oh, you're not saying it right. But, you know, I'm saying it to the best of my capabilities. I just want to encourage you guys to do the same with your children. And I'm just sharing whatever I know with you. And I hope we can all give each other ideas on, you know, what we can do to better our children with Allah and Islam and everything. So So I hope you guys enjoyed this video. And then literally as soon as I'm done reciting those surahs, he's finished his bottle, I'll put the pacifier back in his mouth. He's knocked out. He loves his blanket. He puts his blanket on his cheek. He loves his blanket. And I literally just put him in bed. Sometimes even when I'm done doing that, let's say he wants to get up for whatever reason, I literally say, la'a, khushinemi, like, nope, it's time to go to sleep. And I just put him in bed. And I walk out, as much as it hurts me, but I just walk right out. But yeah, most of the time he's already knocked out, and he loves his bed, alhamdulillah. And yeah, so let me know what your nighttime routine is. Mine's pretty simple. And like I said, consistency is key. Suleiman knows he's gonna have a shower every night. He knows he's gonna brush his teeth, put on his pajamas, his diaper. He's gonna drink his Mrs. Cow, is what we call his bottle. He's gonna drink his Mrs. Cow at night. And he'll have his blanket, and he knows what's coming next. So there's no ifs, ands, or buts. But inshallah, you guys enjoyed this video. I'm gonna make a video as soon as I cut this one off of pretty much what I sound like, because whoever has heard me say it has been like, please just make a video or record it for us, because I know so many people are gonna benefit from it. And as shy as I am to even do it, I will do it for you all, inshallah. All right, so thank you guys so much for watching. Comment down below. Don't forget to like and subscribe, and I will see you guys next week. Assalamu alaikum.